Good morning. Well, it's good morning for me. So this is devlog number 8, and let's go ahead and log in here. And what we're going to see is that it's been 6 days since I last logged in because I have not worked on this game at all this week. I was looking at some basically like the stats of how my videos were doing, these devlogs, and especially with like the last one I worked on, the started working on some art assets. And what I discovered is that after 2 views on that video, what am I pushing myself so hard for? Because art assets are a grind, and yeah, they're not too exciting to talk about for a devlog. So what I decided was, you know what, I'm going to take a break. And that video only got 2 views, and even better, it only got -1 subscribers. I actually lost a subscriber on the last devlog. How awesome is that? That feels great, doesn't it? So yeah, that's why I'm making this devlog, because I did absolutely nothing on this game, and this is the first time I'm playing it after a week, because I needed a mental health break. So I've been working on this game kind of on and off since November, and just recently, actually 8 weeks ago, I decided to put this into alpha, and just kind of like start doing some spread the word, get some eyes on it, see how what the reception is, see how this does performance wise, and basically just make it more visible while I still do the same kind of work I've been doing on it. And what I found out is that there's not really any interest in this, and that's a bummer. And the thing is, with game development, especially at the very beginning, the only person excited about it, actually not even game development, just programming in general, any project you work on, the only person excited about it is you. You may get some other people that are like, oh yeah, that sounds neat, that's such a good idea, but they'll never actually bother to touch it or get involved. And that's just reality. You may have a killer idea in your mind, but it may not be a killer idea for anyone else. That sucks. And that's a big demotivator. And in order to combat that, well, it's good to take a break. It's good to, well, it's not good to get burned out on your own projects. And with game dev especially, there's a good, you need to do some self-imposed like milestones and some goals and things you want to get done. But the important thing is, it's work. And even though you enjoyed programming and making stuff, it's still work. So yeah, taking a break is good. It gives you a chance to kind of step back and reflect and give your brain a rest, because it needs it. You can't just grind every day, be at 100 or 200%, because if you're doing this plus a day job, then oh boy, yeah, you're headed straight for a burnout. And once you get in the burnout state, man, everything just sucks, and everything around you just stops. Not just with work, but with like just life too. You need to take a break. You need a rest. You need to step back, look at things, and that's what I've been doing with this. So I have a good, or my idea with devlog was, you know what, let's just throw out some straight recorded footage without any editing or whatever. Let's see how they do. And going over their stats, so the very first video, you got a total of 18 views, which is awesome. I feel that's very awesome considering my channel has only 53, well, now 52 subscribers. Whoops. So, getting like any views whatsoever is, it feels good. And so with Devlog 2, I was like, okay. So Devlog 1 was, it was cool. Devlog 2 was talking about, wait, no. Devlog 1 was the login and character movement, which was kind of inspired by talking with someone at work, an intern, and, oh man, I need to focus here. I was talking with the intern, because yeah, I teach Python and I was teaching Python at work too. Well, not game dev Python, but just work dev Python, I guess. And I forget what the subject was, but I ended up showing off the character movement and how these characters are put together. Each little segment is its own sprite, and it rotates, and there's no animation with the sprites themselves. And then, oh, I remember now. So yeah, the login. So I was talking about, or he had a question about doing secure logins with websites, and I had just finished implementing Scram login on the game, and so that's kind of led into this discussion. And I was like, you know what? There's enough here to talk about the whole process and make a video of it. And that's exactly what I did. And it got good enough reception, and it got zero people. It got zero people on the Discord. And of course, zero people actually downloading the game and playing it, because that's kind of what I wanted with this alpha, is I wanted some people to play it to see, like, I'll just get some players in here and start getting some feedback about it. And then Devlog 2, I discuss the flow of the game and basically how it works, a general overview of it, and introduce the world boss. Some good info, but it only got 9 views. It still got 1 like, and thank you whoever that one person is that has been liking these videos. And yeah, just general overview. But then Devlog 3. And this one kind of caught me off guard because I was talking, I just made the town builder, and just using the some placeholder graphics and some bare minimum functionality, I was like, there's not that much functionality to show here, but the general idea is here. And I was like, all right, well, just, I mean, it's the dev I did for that week, so I gotta make a video on it. Even though I didn't think it would be that good of content. And even still to this date, the date of this video, it has 32 views, which is, that's more than half of my subscriber count, even with the one missing. Yeah, 32 is a lot for my scrub little channel that has barely any activity on it. And that just kind of blew me away. It still blows me away because the town builder. So, making a mental note of that, and then going like, well, reviewing each of my videos. The whole point of this exercise is to get feedback and suggestions, and if I'm using these metrics, the view count as metrics for that. Then it's saying this game needs to be more of a town builder type game than anything else. So the following week at Devlog 4, we're talking about the mini games. So that's when I had all the mechanics of the mini games put together, and they weren't quite done yet, but there was enough to show and just review in a video. And cool, we have mini games. Awesome. And that got 14 views. I was like, huh. I thought talking about the mini games and all the different types of mini games would get more activity than the town builder. So getting just under half views than the previous week, it's like, that's weird. And it threw me off. So maybe that's part of the problem of this game is like what the idea I'm thinking of it, maybe it isn't good enough, or not good enough, but there's not enough there, or it's not the type of game that people are expecting when they think about this game. Because like these videos are getting impressions, and they pop up in YouTube searches. And when someone sees a video that's, oh, it's a devlog, okay, so this is someone's making a game, and the very next thing is Fantasy Waifu Collector. It's like, what the heck is that? Excuse me, unedited cough. It's like, huh, I wonder what kind of game that is. You know what? It probably sounds like a town builder game, right? Oh, this video, it says town builder right there in the link. That sounds like something I want to play. versus, oh, this is Fantasy Waifu Collector. It's a bunch of mini games? Oh, that's not something I want to play. And yeah, so the part two of that video was mini game mechanics and actually demonstrating the completed mini games of the last two of the capture and or the chase and the I forget the other one, harvest. And that one got 7 views, so even half than the previous one, which is okay. People really aren't thinking of mini games about this. And I was like, all right, well, mini games are done. I mean, all the foundation or all the mechanics are there, and I even got all the like 99% of the art assets done for the capture quest. And that feels good to get done, but it, while it feels good, it doesn't really matter in a sense if no one wants to play it. And that hurts the head. It's like, oh man, what am I doing? I'm putting all this work in into making this thing that no one wants to play. So, it's like, all right, the very next thing is the multiplayer, and I have some foundational code. It pulls in, and it pulls in some details of other people's accounts, and so you can see like their little avatar they set, their username, and in this case, their for the world boss, their score. It's like, cool, surely multiplayer is something that this game is going to draw people in. Post that devlog. And you know what? On the thumbnail, I'm going to put in the story person, the goddess of dragons, because she should be kind of eye-catching just right there on the thumbnail. And because you know what, Fantasy Waifu Collector, here's a dragon goddess. 5 views and not even one like. It's like, oh man, I actually put more than the bare minimum effort on that video. 5 views. It's like, oh, okay. So, have multiplayer functionality in there. That's cool. So, the game functionality is there in almost all areas. At least, and that'll give. Let's see, how do I say this? So, like, there's enough there for someone to play at least a couple hours worth. And that's a lot of content for an alpha. You know what? If I was playing an alpha, I wouldn't expect that much. Because I'm putting a lot into this game, just a lot of variety, and it's probably too much, which is kind of trippy to think about because that's how I like to do things is well, I mean that pops up in just not game dev, but everything in general is scope creep. And it's so easy to scope creep your own projects because you know what? It's fun to think of new things and just add them to the game and just make the best and coolest and everything, all the features. But that doesn't really make a playable product. So it's like, okay, this game, I mean, it needs art assets. I mean, even as I play through this, most of what you see is placeholder graphics. Just absolutely most of it. Like the characters themselves, sure, they have the art assets, but like the background and the icons. Thankfully, the font is free to use. Because I've been doing all the design and layout based around that. So, yeah. Let me start working on the art assets. And I'm like, cool. I shall finish up this. I shall pick a clothing package and work on those art assets. And lo and behold, I just force myself to do it, and I get it done. I post the video, only 2 views. It's been a week, and normally after a week, I'll have at least like what, 5. And so this video that I put out, I put in all this work, and it gets like no actual views or reception. So yeah, and that leads me to think about what I need to do going forward. So thinking about this game, what do I need to focus on? Because like here's the town builder. All of it is art assets, or all of it needs actual art assets. But this part, I wouldn't figure is something that is playable. I mean, this is just kind of a side thing. Like you're just going to place these buildings and they unlock things, they unlock more stuff in the game. And then even this video itself, like me just sitting here playing through it and talking, what exactly is going to be the reception of this? Because, I mean, I haven't done anything. I'm just sitting here yapping about being depressed, you know? So yeah, a break. And then going forward, so instead of doing like a forced devlog video every week, I think I'm going to wrap them around the game features themselves because that way I'll actually have something to show and it'll be about the mechanics and how they work in the game. And if I think about it, about the town builder, like how that got the best reception versus art assets, which is the worst reception. So doing art assets, well, that's not going to get really much of anything done. Yeah, and that's about it. So no more weekly devlogs. Devlogs are gonna come out whenever I freaking feel like it, and they're gonna be these trashy, unedited, this is what you get, verbal garbage. And yeah, I know the YouTube algorithm is going to plays a part of in this as well, but you know what? Whatever. With projects, take a break. Seriously. And you know what? If you're interested in this game, by actually viewing it and viewing these videos and watching the videos, like that gives me a metric to work off of. It'd be cool if you joined the Discord, but you know what? You don't need to. You've clicked on the video. Hopefully you've clicked like, and hopefully you've clicked subscribe and actually added to the subscription number instead of taking away. Yeah. Well, that's it. See you when. You know what? I have no idea when. I'm not setting a time deadline. I'm just going to work on this casually, and let's see what comes of it. All right. If you made it this far, which you probably haven't, but that'd be cool if you did. Yeah. Catch you later.